the weekend. Allow me to see those who are not present yesterday. Can you show by raising up your hand? I want to give you a warm welcome. The my wabo, you are wonderful. You are wonderful. We have been blessed. Thank you so much. Before we proceed with tonight's presentation, allow me to give you a recap of what we discussed last night. Last night, who remembers what was the text of our presentation? Let's be quick, only 2 minutes. Yes, my sister. Tested by a stranger. What were we starting off from this title? We were looking at the family of Solomon when he was visited by the people of Sheba. Where do we find this text? It's from which book? Who remembers? Yes, my sister. From the book of 1 Kings chapter 10 verses 1. If you read it, you will find the king of Sheba visiting Solomon. Now, king of Sheba, she was coming from the Sheba, the land of Sheba. They never worshipped the Lord. They were worshipping the sun, but it was a rich, very rich country. But she was disturbed when she heard the fame of Solomon concerning the name of the Lord. Solomon was the king by Jerusalem, the capital city of worshiping the Lord. She paid a visit. She came with a great train. So Solomon was examined. If you read your Bible, it tells when she came to visit Solomon, she came to test him or to prove him or to ask him hard questions pertaining the name of his Lord. Solomon and the family, they never knew they were in examination. She was like a tinker. She was there for 7 days. So on a daily basis, day number one, she was examining buildings. I even asked ourselves, how are we building in the cities? Do we have the receipt for the window frames, the bricks, the paint? Where do you buy your things? Along? Is it the straightforward way you are doing your things? Solomon was examined, and on buildings, he passed. Do you remember very well? He is the one who built the temple, of which not even one has reached the standard of the temple which was built by Solomon. Up until today, the temple by Jerusalem is of his standard. Solomon number two, he was tested on the food on his temple, the servants, those who served before him, the dressing, they examined him on all spheres of life. Then God, Solomon, passed all the examination. Would you say amen for Solomon's family? After passing the examination, on the last day, she was now examining Solomon, how he worships the Lord. You remember, he went to the temple. Everybody tools down, they went to worship the Lord by the temple. When she was there by the temple, seeing how orderly, how organized the service was, we are told the king of Sheba fainted. This is on verse number 8. When it was done, people had to pray for her. She was risen again. Oh, when she was born, she said, help me by your people, help me by your servants. Everybody is happy. Everybody is happy. Happy, happy, happy. Everyone by Solomon's house, they were happy. So last child, we were encouraging each family member to be happy. Tell somebody you must be happy by your home. Thank you so much, may the good Lord bless us. So tonight, we are going to look at this title, which is saying, three special messages from Jesus. When God was speaking to his church, we are going to look at the book of Revelation, chapter 2 and chapter 3, when Jesus was speaking to those 7 churches by the Asia Minor. But there are 3 special messages, which were almost the same 7 times to each church. We are going to be looking at those messages, and they are also supposed to help us as a family of God, as a church. Are we together, brothers and sisters? So this is our subject tonight. 3 special messages from Jesus from the families. Be prepared to be blessed. Remember to pray for me as I will be doing this presentation. May the good Lord bless us. The first verse is only the introduction from the book of Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter 3, verses 1 up to 3. Can you read it for me, my brother? 1 Samuel chapter 3, verses 1 up to 3. I only have 30 minutes, so we are going to be a little bit faster. Can you read it for me, my brother?
Lying down with his
I was looking at this son, which the Bible is telling us at this time. He was a priest by the temple. And it's almost equivalent with this time which we are living in these times. It says, truly at this time, the word of the Lord was rare. The word of the Lord was scarce. No open vision. They were worshiping the Lord anyhow. People were no longer concerned. As family members, how are you worshiping the Lord? Are you serious? Do you have morning prayers by your house? Do you have afternoon prayer or evening prayer? Do we even gather? Or it's like in your days one day. One man bear. God for us all. How are you doing it as a family? It is dangerous not to uplift the family altar. It will be like in these days. The word of the Lord was rare. No open vision, the Lord Church of God. Not only that, he also early, it is saying he was also not able to visualize. He was also edge. Mr. Sean about Bona Anga Bonamans. Hello? Could not visualize very well. It was almost going. And also the other thing, the light by the temple was almost dying. So please, my brothers and my sisters, let us leave the family altar, number one, uplift the family altar. Number two, we must be families who depend on the Lord through prayer always. For the good Lord to communicate to us these special messages, we need to be constant on prayer. The special message number one, we're going to read it from the book of Revelation chapter 2, verses 2 and 3, verses 9, 13 and 19 is the same message. Rev chapter 2, verses 2 and 3, 9, 13 and 19. Can you read it, my brother? Please, can you just be attentive as you're reading for us? Try to raise up your voice, my brother. Read on.
Revelation 2, 2.
Uh-huh.
I know your deeds.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I know that you cannot ever get wicked men.
Yes.
That you have tested those who claim to be apostles, but you have to force. You have persevered that you are catching my
name. Uh-huh. You are missing number? Verse number 3. Listen to the good Lord talking to his people. God is saying, I know your hard work. I know your situation. In times like this, when the world is almost crumbling, hello, my brothers and my sisters, when what you think you have been trying to achieve in this world, when all hope seems to be lost, are we together, my brothers and my sisters? When you have just received a letter that there's no more employment here, when you have graduated with the PhDs, you have several degrees, but work is not coming back. The good Lord is saying to you and me tonight, I know your situation. Tell the next person, God knows. God knows. Verse number 9.
I know your afflictions
and your poverty. I know your afflictions and your poverty.
Yes, you are.
By our woman, it's not the Gunabad. It's starting to be good. I know your afflictions and your poverty. God knows. Some of you might be coming to worship God here at Beacon of Hope. Whereby when the people by the location hearing that there's Beacon of Hope, they're afraid coming here. They think, it's changed. For the Sabbath, it's church for those who are the focus, it's church for those who are able, hello. But when now, here at Beacon of Hope, they know you're putting on same dress, one dress. Every day it's like the flag of Zimbabwe that we doesn't change. God knows your poverty. God knows your situation. Yes, you work in the city center. I work in the city center, but not even a single day have you managed to buy yourself a decent car. You just passed by those chicken inn. You just passed by Holiday Inn. You have never been in there. Hello. The you wrestle with them. No certain, if you try to change your debt, it will go for certain mass. That's when you can afford yourself a decent lunch. God says, I know your situation. Your poverty, I know. Your afflictions, I know. What you are going to, He know. Verse number 19. Little, my brother, let me 20 minutes.
I know where you live.
I know where you live. Number one. Where you live, where I live, God knows. Yes, He knows. Even some of you have paid rent for this man. You are staying from my heart. He knows. You pleaded with the landlord. Please just have mercy on me, please. We haven't been given money, but please have mercy on me. You are on your ear. He knows. The Greek word for this word, allow me to tell you, the knowledge which man goes to school to acquire is called gnosko. He acquired the knowledge. But the knowledge which God has, he does not need to go to school to have knowledge alone. He knows the cause for things to happen is because of him. He is the causative of all things. That is called oida. Oida. For God knows what is going to happen before it happens. So this God is concerned about our families. He's saying tonight, I want to tell you something. So message number one, God knows. You want verse number what? 18, read verse number 19. Let's see what the good Lord said to us.
So that's number one.
we are so much sought into sin to an extent before the Lord, anyone who commits sin must die there and there. But because of Jesus Christ, you are alive. You were supposed to be dead today. Because of what you did, that small life, you were supposed to be taken to Dabs, Nyaranzo, or Kotakai. He knows. Read your message number two. Can you read for me, my brother? Let's just try to be a little bit faster. Read verse 19, man. There's a message. Read verse 19. Yes. I know what it is. Your love and faith.
Your service and perseverance.
Your serving and perseverance. Service and perseverance. Yes, they are there. It's only you who is good. Some are there. Hello? Sure. Is it true? Then you can apply a lesson to the proper way. Yes, you can apply the proper way. It is you who is corrupt. Because what he's saying to you and to me tonight, I know your perseverance. I know you have been afflicted. I know yes, you have to soldier on challenges you are facing. But you say, that's message number one. Remain faithful to the Lord. While the people are busy mimicking the world, instead of the world mimicking the church, this is the time you must be faithful on this God. As a family member. God knows. Message number two. Revelation chapter 3. Verses chapter 5. Chapter 3, verse 5, 12 and 21. Same message. Can you read for us, my brother?
Pambini, but that is all the zone.
clothes will be raised to those who overcome. Hello? Not here on earth, but tell somebody to be with this one. Hello? Please overcome. You overcome us. What are you supposed to overcome? Any sin. Overcome any test of sin, overcome. You overcome us, don't be dressed on white. Number two, you overcome us, it is saying here. You overcome us, what are they going to be done by Christ? Their names are going to be written in the books of life. By the way, the good Lord operates like an accountant. Hello? He uses three books. Book number one. Oh, the book of those who refuse the Lord. He says their names will be recorded on the ground. Hello? Their names will be written on the ground. What does this mean? You are depositing yourself with the hell here I come. Book number two, hello? Hello? There's the book of life and the other book of what? The book of remembrance. Those, the deeds of everybody. So this book of remembrance, so the good God, I've said he will be working like an accountant. This is the ledger book, this is the journal, this is the cash book. All in the journal will be posted to the cash book so that it will balance very well. Hello, what do we call? Those on with the names of the book of remembrance, they're supposed also to be in the book of life. Your name must be in the book of life. Special message from Jesus. You must not miss your name as a family member. Your dad must be in this book. Your wife must be in this book. Your sons and daughters, their names, they must be in this book. Are we together, church? Ask somebody, is your name in? What you do on a daily basis makes your name readable. What I will do, there's no other miracle. The secret is your deeds, my deeds, will make my name appear in the book of life. There's this song. Sorry, allow me to sing this one. It is sung in the vernacular with the people from Togo, with their accent. Hello? Raka nyori wari katsima. It is written in the book of life. That's your duty, and that's my task. Hello? Why? Because the days we are living, they are always the same days which Eli was living. Number one, no prophet vision in the world. Number two, the light was soon going off. Number three, the word of the Lord was read. Is your name written? So the good Lord says, overcome. You must overcome. I must overcome. Message number three. You read verse 21, my brother. Alright, it says, whereby the name will present the book of life, I'll make him a pillar in the Lord's temple. So it makes it says, you are going to be heavenly candidate. Overcomers shall sit with the Lord. And Jesus says, he is the Lord. Overcomers, that's good news. You are going to be with the Lord forever and ever. Where there's no more sorrow, where there's no more death, where there's no more. You see, Monday they're approaching. The family happiness is stolen. Hello? Because you don't have school fees. You want to provide the family with the shelter. You want to provide with the clothing. These are the challenges the families are facing. But God says, no, don't worry. I know all that. But what I want you, you must overcome. Tell somebody, did you pick this way? Please, the Lord is telling us. Tell him, please, overcome, man. Message number three, we are going to read from the book of Revelation, chapter 3, verses 6, 13, and 21, the third message, chapter 3, verse 6, 13, and 21, read on, my brother.
Yes,
Yes.
Some were eating cooking cow free, some were eating those flowers. This one does this, this one does
to him. Whoever we have an opportunity of eating, it leaves, it is saying, whoever will eat it, number one, it heals death. No more death for you. Number two, hello, the moment you eat those leaves, no more aging. My sisters, you have faced challenges. Hello, those people have troubled you. You have used the different zona. You have used the different voice, the doubts. You have used the new dawn. You have used more vent. All those you have tried, but it's not working. Scolded you, ah, this one she's so dark. This one she's so light. As if it was you, oh, you were the baby. Hello?
Hello.
Like, you know, when they see me, they say, I'm the colored guy. I am a homo. Hello?
It's not my own making. Hello? I'm just born like this. I have got good news. If there is a complexion for heaven, no, it is going to be done. The miracle is going to be done by the tree of life. Hello?
Where they say manna, not even one. They say their pizza, They said they are chakazote. Omaluso, Amazondo, no they will save, no bro. But this bread of heaven, manna, if you always wonder how was it looking like? How was it tasting? Please plan and prepare to go to heaven. There will be manna for you. Manna for me. There will be manna for everybody. The overcomers, we have the opportunity of enjoying manna. My last verse. Read this one, my brother. What is this one, my brother? Revelation 3, verse 16 and 17. As I prepare to wind my presentation and make an appeal, please just do 3 minutes, please, as you are about to go. Verse 6, 16 and 17, Revelation 3.
Verse 16.
Yeah.
So, because you are
there, uh-huh.
Did I go to
the home? Yes.
I am about to speak to you out.
Uh-huh.
Verse 17.
Yes.
You say, I am rich.
Mm-hmm.
I am quiet, lost, and you not really
can take. Uh-huh.
But you don't realize that you are wretched.
My man. What a combination. It is better if you're only blind. But this combination is worse. You are wretched, you are pitiful, you are poor, you are blind, and you are naked. What a combination. The problem I have is I look warm. Hello? I'm neither hot nor cold. I look warm. The good Lord says, no, please be warned. I'm about to speak to you because of your deeds. I'm about to record you. You are useless. You are supposed to behave like a candidate, but you are not a candidate for him because of what I'm doing or what you are doing. Are we together, Jake? I have a friend who is blind. Yet to understand, I wanted to understand that the good Lord cares for everybody. One day we went to the disability day by the church. He was invited to share with us. When he was coming there by the pulpit, somebody was assisting him, the elder. He was holding his stick. He said when he was addressing the church, "Don't sympathize on me because I am blind. I thank the good Lord because I'm blind." I said, "What is he saying now? Don't sympathize with me because I'm blind." He said, "Yes, I want to thank the Lord. In our family, we were 10, and I was number 5. But because I was blind, my parents refused me the opportunity to go to school at the age of 6. They said, no, because he's blind, he is useless. He cannot go to school until a certain man came along my way. I was 12 by then." He said, "It convinced my parents. My dad said, please, 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 this son cannot go to school. He's just useless. Let him stay here and we'll die. I'll take care of him." He said, no. There's a school for the blind in Masingo. Said, "I was taken to Masingo. When he was there, he called grade 1. Said, from grade 1 to grade 7, I have never known number 2. My position was always number 1. I wrote the grade 7, but then they were only writing 2 subjects, Math and English. Said there were 2 ones. Proceeded to writing JC, he had 9 ones. He went on for the whole level, he had 8 A's, 1 B, and the B was in short. Proceeded to the university, but then there were only 2 universities in Zimbabwe. It was only the Solution University and the University of Zimbabwe. He was enrolled by the University of Zimbabwe. What did he need to start? He had to start law. Say, I thank God. Don't sympathize with me because I'm blind. Say, you want to thank this God because I'm blind. Out of his family members, the family of 10, there's not even one who has managed to go to the university except him. Whilst he was there, he started, he came out with the class 5 cars. He said, now out of 10, he prayed to God, but he said, no, not only that was enough. Now he is now a judge. Hello? Where did you- Why am I leaving you? And he went on and said, if you hear I have stolen, it is not me, but somebody with eyes has led you to commit the sin. My baby now doubt that it's not me, somebody would have led me. He said, now I have no change. He's moving around with those big cars. He's got an egg. He said, no, oh, what I can do? They said, somebody must guide you. I now have to go to look one of my family members. He's now my aide. He assists me on what I dress on a daily basis. If he makes a mistake of dressing me with things which do not match, he is fired.
Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Thank you so much.